Yes, welcome. Today we are going to be learning about motion. I gave you some assignments, isn't it? And you've done it, isn't it?
So go through this,
then we'll look at those assignments. Motion. What is motion? What is motion? Every day in our everyday life, we encounter this phenomenon known as motion. This morning, you came from your house to this place, isn't it? So what did you do? What brought you from your house to this place? Walking. Movement, isn't it? Motion. Movement from one point to the what? Other. The movement from point A to point what? B. That is what? Motion. That is what you do every day. Is that clear?
Yes.
And there are different kinds of these what? Motion. Do you know that the earth revolves around the sun? The earth revolves around the what? Sun. Making a motion in a circular what? Path. Isn't it? Then when you on the fan in your house, the fan blows you by making motion in a what? Circular what? Path. Isn't it? Now when you're driving your car and you're driving from in front of tclassify.com to what's the name of the bakery down there? No, the one on this side. G9. Do you know G9 Bakery?
Yes.
When you are driving your car to G9, you follow through a straight path, is it not?
Yes.
You're making a what we call rectilinear motion. Motion in a linear path. Isn't it?
Yes.
Now, when you have smoke or particles of very light object, you put them inside your hand, you blow them. When they go, they move in what we call zigzag manner. They move in what we call what? Zigzag manner. Is that clear? Have you been able to identify different types of motion? So motion could be in straight path. It could be in vibrational. Like when you plug the string of a guitar, you know what a guitar is?
Yes.
You plug the string, what will happen? To move to and fro. That is a what? What kind of motion? Vibrational motion. You understand? So from my explanation, you will be able to understand that we have different kinds of what? Motion. Different kinds of what?
Motion.
And that is what we are going to learn today. Because motion is a very important primary aspect of what? Physics. Very important primary aspect of what? Physics. Now, the motion of an object can be defined as the visible what? Movement between two points. And which may be caused by an applied what? Force. Motion is always caused by an applied what?
Force.
Is that clear?
Yes.
When you blow the little grain, it is due to the force from your breath, isn't it?
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So it's always force or energy that brings about what? Motion. Now, the study of objects in motion and the force associated with them is called what? Dynamics. Is that clear? The study of objects in motion and the force associated with them is called dynamics. Then that aspect that deals with objects in motion is known as what? Kinematics. Is that clear?
Yes.
So those two important things you're going to know while we go into the various types of what? Motion. Have you written down the notes?
Yes.
Please, make sure you get down the notes. So we look at types of what? Motion. Types of motion. And Jamb is going to ask you in the options listed below which of the following is a vibrational motion. You should be able to pick out a vibrational motion from the other types of motion, isn't it? So number one, we'll talk about translational or displacement motion. That's number one. Translational stroke displacement motion. This is the number one type of motion that we're looking at. And this is the motion of an object in a straight line as a result of the force applied. This is the motion of an object in a straight line as a result of the force applied. Example is the motion of a woman pushing her baby's pram from one point to another in a straight line, isn't it? You can also say that example is the motion of a wheelbarrow pusher, isn't it? Wheelbarrow pusher moving a luggage from point A to what? B in a what? In a what?
Straight line.
For you to call it a translational or displacement motion or rectilinear motion, it has to be in a what? It has to be in a what? Because then we'll ask you the movement that that happens when you drive your car from point A to point B in a straight line is what? You understand? Then it would also ask you the movement of the tire of the car that you're driving is what? You know the movement of the tire is not the same thing as your movement of the whole body of the car,
yes.
Is it?
Yes.
One is making a what? Rotational, isn't it?
Yes.
Whereas the other one is making a what? Rectilinear what? Motion. Very important. So once it's a straight line, then you talk about translational. Now number two is what we call oscillatory in brackets vibratory motion. You can give me an example of a vibratory motion, which I just said now.
String of a guitar,
movement of a string of a guitar when it is what? Plucked. When it is what?
Plucked.
You can give me another example. Pendulum. Simple pendulum, is it not? It makes this motion. It comes from where it started, goes back. So whenever you have such motion, you're talking about vibratory motion. Vibratory motion is the motion of a body about a fixed point. Is a motion of a body about a fixed point. That is the motion that repeats itself in equal intervals of time along the same path. That is a motion that repeats itself at equal intervals along the same path. That is what we call vibratory motion. Copy the notes. Copy the notes. I can clear up translational motion, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So that I can make a sketch of what vibratory motion looks like. So this is a simple pendulum, which I know that you are very much conversant with. You have the body that is suspended on the rope. It moves to this place and comes back. It moves, goes back. You understand? It's moving along the same what? Path. Can you see the path? This same path continues this motion, isn't it? Whenever this is the initial body, you plug it a little, isn't it? Then it continues moving like this, along the same path. Is that clear? So this is what we call a what? Vibratory or what?
Oscillatory
motion. So you have to suspend it and rig it support. So this is the body that is doing the what? Vibration. And this is what we call a what? simple what? Pendulum. This is a what?
Simple
pendulum. Simple pendulum. Now, another good example. They are going to draw these sketches for you and say what kind of motion is being illustrated in the sketch. You should be able to pick out the motion, isn't it?
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Because you know the example. Now, we'll talk about a helical spring. We'll talk about a what?
Helical
spring. If you suspend a helical spring, this is suspend a load on it. Then what do you need to do? What do? Pull it down a little bit, isn't it?
Yes.
Pluck it. Then it will start making this motion along the same path, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Continuous motion. And such motion is an example of what? Oscillatory or what?
Vibratory.
Good. So this one is what we call what? Helical spring. So with these two examples, you can give me three examples of a vibratory motion. But Samuel, give me one example of a vibratory motion.
It's mainly in a car. That is
no, give me from the ones that I've given you. From the ones you've said so far, vibratory motion. Emmanuel, give me one. Motion of a simple pendulum ball. Thank you. Samuel, give me one. Motion of a helical spring. So give me one then. Motion of a plucked string of a guitar. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Haven't I said that before?
Yeah.
I've said it. Now we're going to quickly move over to another kind of motion known as rotational motion. Known as what?
Rotational
motion. That's the third style of motion. Rotational motion. Rotational motion. This is the motion of a body that moves in a cycle or ellipse and rotates about an axis. This is the motion of a body in a what? Cycle or ellipse. It's the motion of a body in a cycle or ellipse about an axis. About an axis. That's the definition of the rotational motion. And I give us instances, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
One good example is the rotation of fan blades about a fixed point. Example is the rotation of fan blade. You know what fan blade is?
Yes.
About a fixed axis. Please, can I clean the sketches that I made?
Yes, sir.
So that I can sketch that of a fan blade so that you see how it does the circular motion. This is the fixed point of the blade. Then you have the blades. So you can tell me what happens when you go and press the button of on. What happens? It will start making what? Circular. Is it not a circle?
Yes.
Is it not a circle? Circular. Call it rotational. You understand? Whenever you're making a movement in a circular path, call it rotational motion. So a good example is what? The rotation of blade about a fixed point. You understand? And then it's going to ask you which of the following is a rotational motion. Movement of a string of a plucked guitar. Movement of the helical spring. Movement of a simple pendulum. Movement of the blade of a fan. Which one is the answer? Good. And we are going to talk about another form of motion known as random motion. Known as what?
Random
motion. Which can I clean up?
Yes,
which of them can I clean up?
Yes,
The downward.
So the fourth type of motion is what? Random motion. Random what? Motion. This is a type of motion with no specific direction. Random motion is a type of motion with no specific direction. Random motion is a type of motion with no specific direction. Have I given us an instance of a random motion?
Yes.
Emmanuel, did I give such?
Yes.
What did I give as the example?
Small grain or dust, you understand?
And blow it, is it?
Yes.
The particles will move in a random zigzag manner. That is an example of a what? Random motion.
And Jump is gonna ask you, the kind of motion that takes a zigzag form with no specific direction is what? The right rotational, vibratory, random, rectilinear. What will be the answer?
Random motion. You see? Those are the forms in which it comes, the question. Example is the zigzag motion often exhibited by gas molecules. Example is what? The zigzag. What's the meaning of zigzag? Random, with no specific direction. Zigzag motion exhibited by what? Gas molecules. All of you are chemistry students, aren't you?
Yes.
You know that gas molecules, they move in zigzag direction, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Because their density, their mass is very small, so they move in no specific direction. Another example is the movement of pollen particles in water. The what? Movement of pollen. You know what pollen is? Pollen particle, pollen grain, the particles in what? Water. You find out that everything that is very small that you put in water can move in a zigzag manner, isn't it? Anything that has very little mass, isn't it, Emmanuel? It's possible. Now, finally, we look at the last form of motion known as circular motion, known as what? Circular motion. And we are going to identify, and I want you to observe the difference between a circular motion and a rotational motion. Difference between a what? Circular motion and what? Rotational motion. After explaining what a circular motion is, I would like you to identify for me the difference between a what? Circular and what? Rotational. I've given you the definition of a rotational motion, isn't it?
Yes.
So check it out. Circular motion is the motion of an object in a circle at a constant speed. Number 5, circular motion. I will say that it is the motion of a body in a cycle at a what? Constant speed. Speed. Write it down. The movement of a body in a cycle at a constant speed. Example is the movement of the earth round the sun or the moon round the earth. Example is the movement of the sun round the earth or the moon round the movement of the earth, this earth round the sun or the moon round the what? Earth. I hope I can claim the random motion definition. Good. Now, Who can tell me the difference between a circular motion and a rotational motion, which is an every year question in jam? It comes out every year. I'm going to explain it with a simple diagram of the sun. Can you see the sun? Can you see the sun?
Yes.
What revolves around the sun?
Earth,
isn't it?
Yes.
The what? Earth. You understand? Now, whenever this earth is moving around the sun, it is making two types of motion. Whenever the earth is moving around the sun, it is making how many types of motion? Two types of motion. One of the motion brings about day and night, whereas the other one brings about the year. Is that clear? When the sun, when the earth makes a complete revolution, it clocks one what? One what? Year. But as the sun, let's say this is the sun, and I'm the earth, and I'm moving around, this is what we call circular motion. This is what we call what? Circular motion.